Hey guys, I hope that everybody's doing okay. I almost didn't get on camera today because I'm still in my bonnet. I'm still sick. I'm still not feeling well. But you know what? I want to come on here to say wicked people have lost. You know, God brought me to Psalm 118 recently, and I think it's about 29 verses. So I encourage you guys to read that scripture, and it gave me so much hope and restoration, even in my heart, for just some of the things that I've been going through, you know. And I don't want to sit here and wallow in sorrow and wallow in defeat and wallow in, you know what, you know, this and that. You know, I want to walk in the spirit that God has given me, and He's given me the spirit, His Holy Spirit, and it's not a fear. And every day, even in my heart, even in my soul, even in the pit of my stomach, I can walk in the joy and the peace of the Lord because I know that I'm not gonna lose, just like the ones that are mentioned, the wicked people that are mentioned in the Bible. You know, if you go to the Word of God, God does not like people just being wicked and indulging in other gods and doing as they please in their wickedness and, you know, in their sinful and in their willful sins. He does not like that. God does not like that. So why should we like that? You know, you remember what he did to Satan. I was talking to my mother the other day. He kicked Satan and a third of the angels out of heaven for what they did to him. They came up against him, you know, and sealed their fate. He sealed their fate. They are going to burn in the lake of fire along with anyone else who is going to come up against God in any way. And I'm sorry, but if you're a wicked and you're an evil person and you refuse to repent and tell God that you are sorry for the things that you have done towards him and towards his people, towards his chosen royal priesthood people, his elect, that's what my mother was calling them, his elect, you know, then you deserve the same fate. You know, if you have resorted to a life of bringing the people that you see have the light in them and that shine in them and that have chosen to repent and live a life after God and have chosen the right way and the righteous path, and they've got God's righteous hand upon their life, then you deserve to go to the pit of hell. You know, you do. And that is not me being mean. When I read Psalm 18, I was like, wow, you know, I don't wish bad for anyone. I really don't. I don't wish bad for anyone. I don't wish anyone to go anywhere. You know, I don't wish any, I wish that you guys would receive the joy and the peace that comes when you just turn away from yourself, when you turn away from that life, that wicked and evil life that you are holding on to, that you're clinging on to, gossiping about everybody, drinking, smoking, acting stupid. You know, I wish that you would turn your life around and give your life to Jesus and say, I'm sorry. 'Cause you don't know what life you're missing, you know, what you can have when you turn yourself over to Jesus, you know? You don't know what you're missing. You don't know what you're missing. You know, you think that you are the one intimidating people, going around making people upset and going around and excuse me. I'm gonna get this out, Satan. I'm gonna get this out. Going around making people feel like I'm the best, you know. I can you know, just irritating people and intimidating people and bringing people down and manipulating people and just acting like you were some god or something. You are living a sad existence. You really are. You're living a very sad existence. And I'm sorry to be so bold to say this on here, but Me and so many others are so tired of you guys doing that. But thank God we have our joy and our peace, and we have our salvation in the Lord, you know. And every time that you come up against us, we have the word of God to come back against you, you know. We have the joy of the Lord to come back against you because it lives inside of us. We are the light. We are the light, and that's what you can't stand. Because you don't have that. And it's so sad that you resorted to bringing us down for it. You know, that's your existence. To just talk bad, be mean, stomp on us, you know. It's crazy. And all I can do is pray for you. And all I can do is leave you in God's hand, just like David did in Psalm 118, you know. This is the day that the Lord has made, and I shall what? Rejoice and be glad in it. Like he said in Psalm 118, 24. I am going to be glad in it. And you know what? I understand now what happens to you if you do not give your life over. And that's not me being mean. That's not me being evil in any way, because the Bible says it. God does not like that. He doesn't like that. And you could be a chosen one too. You can be a chosen one too. All you need to do is submit your life and your heart to God and open up your heart to him and tell him you're sorry. You can have the better way too. The light that you're stomping other people in over, that's in them, you can have as well. And that's all it is. You're just jealous that they have that light. But you could have it too. But you're just too stubborn and too foolish, you know, to go after it like they have. They did the work. We've done the work. We've done the work. And you've got to pick up your cross and do the work. But it is the better way. It's the better life. You can have it too. You know? So, I'm sorry, y'all. I guess I'm seeing now that they've lost. The wicked have lost, you know? And if they don't ever get it right and they don't ever turn away from their sin, they've lost. And God will take his vengeance against them. He will. And just like God has come down on me and you, and we turned our lives around, they have the same opportunity to turn their lives around and do the work, but they've got to do the work. So I can't live my life feeling sorry about them every day, all day. I can't do that. I've got to go and do what God has called me to do for him and continue to do the work in him, through him, for him, with him, by him, you know? I can't continue to worry about what the wicked people are doing against us and against me. All I can do is pray for them and move on with my assignment and in my life. And that's exactly what I'm going to do. And I'm sorry that I'm, for my appearance, guys, I'm sorry for my voice. I'm sorry that I don't have a voice. But I'm still going to power through this video because I feel like a lot of us need to hear this. That we need to stop worrying so much about what they're doing and how they're coming against us. And we need to go on and carry our crosses and be in the joy and the peace and the love that God has given us. And stop worrying about them. Stop worrying about them. Stop worrying about them. Stop worrying about them. Their fate is sealed if they don't get it right with God. They don't get it right with God. And that's all we can pray for them to do, is to get it right with God and move on about our lives and be in our joy and our peace. And be in the word and be in love, you know, that's what we've got to continue to do. We've got to. So I love you guys. I'm going to continue to lift you guys up in prayer. I pray that you guys continue to lift me and my family up in prayer as well, me and my children, because, yeah, we've got to get through this, y'all. I love y'all. Hope y'all have a good day. Bye.